So guys, I'm up here on Thomas Street, and I'm up to visit Chris and the Liberty Super Run, and the volunteers that come up here and give so kindly to the people of the community. And not only the people of the community, but people from all over Dublin are coming. There's foreign people, there's Dublin people, there's all sorts of people coming. And they're queuing up now to get some of the presents kindly donated by people from the Liberties, for people in need. And they do this not just for Christmas, guys. This is not just a Christmas gig. This is something that goes on right throughout the year. Chris, the Liberty Super Run, put together to try and help members of their own community here. It's a fantastic sort of organisation they have. And they get absolutely no help from the Irish government. It's a shame on the Irish government. I mean, no help whatsoever. So I'm going to take you now just to have a look around behind and see what the crack is. The guys are still just getting set up. And then they're going to start giving out all the nice gifts that people donated. Okay, here on the 23rd of December, we're out and about. Like I say, you guys do this all year round.
Get these ready by 7:30 and then we'll head down Dame Street, or down Thomas Street, then down Dame Street, up Grafton Street, and then do a loop back around through the Liberties to here, yeah.
And tell me, how many times a week is this done?
It's only once a week now. It used to be twice a week, but they stopped doing it twice a week. The van just goes out on a flight, you know, instead of the stop.
Oh, yeah. This is done without any help from the government?
Yeah, yeah, the whole thing, just from donations, yeah.
Tell me about yourself, Callum. Why do you do this?
I just was in a rough spot a couple of months ago, and Chris helped me out, so I'm repaying him by doing this. Well, Chris is the organizer. He organized the whole thing. Yeah.
All this wouldn't exist without Fran and Chris. And,
yeah, Fran
and
too.
Is like you,
yeah, I suppose so. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Fair play to young.
We enjoy it. Yeah.
Out doing something decent.
Yeah, yeah.
Just the hard work. How do you feel when you're
good? Good. Yeah. I do it most weeks now, once a week. So.
And what does it mean to you just to be doing this?
It's just good to help people, you know what I mean? You feel better doing it, and other people feel better getting helped as well, you know what I mean? So.
It's a winner's all round, bro, isn't it?
Exactly, yeah. Some people just want to chat to you as well, so.
Bro, fair play to you, and thanks for your civil service.
Yeah, and no worries at all,
yeah. True sense of the word.
Yeah.
You know, going out and doing something for people in need. Yeah. Need more people like you, good man yourself.
Yeah, no worries.
All right.
Cheers, man.
I think the last couple of weeks more so now is just absolutely crazy, you know. I think the other day I counted on my phone, 102 phone calls in one day. I think probably about 30 or 40 messages, WhatsApp, sure. Just people looking for help for Christmas, you know. Not only homeless people, people struggling, you know, just families broken, just hopeless.
Any update with the any help from the government?
No, look at Paul, to be honest with you, we gave up. We gave up. We don't need the government, because I'll tell you what, because you'll see here, everything here is donated by the public. The public are better than their government, and that's being honest with you. They're a thousand times better. You know, we've asked so many times for help. You see the work that they're doing. They're trying to shut us down. Trying to shut us down. You know, they're coming up with all these rules that we have to. This is a coffee now coming in. Thanks, Nate. But as I said, Paul, they're trying to shut us down. Why? They're trying to say we're harming these people. Can you tell me where you would see harm here?
That's crazy, bro.
Can you tell me where you can see harm, please?
You know? People getting looked after. That's all it's
so
all around.
They're trying to say we're harming the homeless people. These people are struggling, need help, you know? And only for yourself and the public, and donations coming in of clothes, toiletries, whatever, vans, insurance, diesel vouchers, everything. Without that, you know.
Chris, tell me, is there any people you think would like to take the opportunity to shout out?
Yeah, there is. There's a lot of shout outs. So basically, there's a couple in Selbridge that are called Pat and Ada, and they've been with Liberty Super, and I walked with Pat on the Tiglin bus as well. I just want to give everybody in Selbridge a big shout out. I want to give everybody in the Liberties an amazing community we live in. Everybody, I can't name everybody, but you all know who it is for the donations, whether it's clothes, whether it's food, whether it's money, whether it's diesel vouchers, whether it's support, anything. Just thank you so much to everybody in the Liberties. Anybody that's, just everybody that donates us, but you know, if a list this long, I'd never go through it. But, sorry, especially all of our volunteers, I just wanted to give them the biggest shout out ever. These guys, 7 nights a week, put their heart and soul into Liberty Super, going out on their own free time, giving up their own free time in these cold nights. They're amazing, absolutely. And without them guys, but you can see them there, look at, without them guys, Paul, this is not possible. So a big shout out to them. And just want to say Happy Christmas to everybody, and look at, Liberty Super, and we'll keep doing what we're doing, you know. We'll keep providing.
Your vision for the 2022 now with Liberty Super?
Our vision is to grow more, Paul. Our vision is to get recovery houses, to get, you know, we're in talks with we're meant to be meeting a man now very soon, a big businessman that might be able to help us in a recovery home, stuff like that. So, look at, Liberty Super is going to grow. It's sad it has to happen, but it is going to happen.
Absolutely, yeah. Chris, it wasn't for people like you, it certainly inspired me.
Yeah, thanks, Paul.
You really have, Paul. Yeah. And, I just think, and I know you've inspired a lot of other people, I'm just talking to the two young people there tonight that were gone out. The trolleys.
Yeah, really, the walk down, teams, yeah.
Downtown to feed the homes that can't get up there.
Yeah.
I mean, geez, there's no more you could be doing, brother.
No, we can't, look at, I said to my wife, what, we have to go and do our Christmas shopping at 12 o'clock tonight if we hadn't had the time. So we're going to Dunn Stores at 12 o'clock tonight to do our own job. That's how caught up we were in the helping people. Okay. Not that we're giving out, I love doing it, but tomorrow is kind of...
For anybody watching,
yeah.
Chris's son and his wife are over there drafting
today. Yeah.
They are here supporting you. Every,
amazing.
Every,
gig. Boy, me side all the time. But again, I just want to say, I loved helping everybody, but tomorrow, we're just kind of winding down. It's just family time tomorrow for me, you know. But volunteers, Liberty Super will still be running. The van will be still out and the volunteers will be getting stuck in. We'll be out Christmas Day for a few hours on the van. And hopefully we'll have a few Christmas dinners. We're waiting for a bit of feedback on that. But yeah, so look, again, thanks to everybody for listening. And Paul, I want to give you a big shout out as well. Amazing man. Anybody subscribe to Paul's channel, give him a follow, watch his interviews, powerful stuff going on Cold Turkey. So Merry Christmas to you all, and thank you.
Wonderful, Chris, thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Lorian, is it?
It is indeed.
Lorian, I just saw you brought in big boxes and bags and sandwiches to the Liberty Super on there.
Yeah.
Is that something you do often? Or,
almost every Thursday.
When did you start doing that?
Oh God, it's over a year now.
It's wonderful. It's people like yourself able to keep this place open.
Oh, thank God we're able to help. Okay, but for the grace of God, go every one of us.
Absolutely, though. And it's just, when did you hear about the Liberty Super owner? How did you come?
I actually started going down to it in Cork Street. They worked in Cork Street there for a while. I had got word up, I live in Ballyfermot, and we got word up there that they needed help. So we went down, and we'd done that for a couple of weeks, and then they moved up here. So we come up here, there's a bigger need up here.
Absolutely.
So it's great to be able to help them. My God.
It is a privilege, isn't it?
God was good to me over the years, so, you know, give it a little bit back.
That's wonderful. That's a message that we want to get out into the air tonight, because it's so important, I think, that people that have the comfortable can give a little back, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And I've been lucky. And you see people, and you're looking at all them people there giving all that, all their time. You know, I mean, what I do is nothing towards what they do. It only takes me a couple of hours to make a few sandwiches.
No. Oh, it's wonderful what you do, though. And it's great, and you can see that some of these people are in need.
Oh, God, yeah. Oh, it's a break your heart if you're standing there. I don't know how they do that.
Honestly, God.
Oh, I've cried sometimes.
And I hope you have a wonderful Christmas.
Thank you very much.